In this illustration, we'll discuss about the phase difference in SHMs of two simple pendulums. Here, the figure shows two pendulums A and B, which are projected with the speeds V1 and V2 at t equals to 0 from the position we can see here. And we are required to find the phase difference between the two pendulums in their simple harmonic motions. So, the very first thing we can do here is to calculate the amplitudes of these two motions. Here we can see this pendulum A in initial position is at a distance L alpha from the initial position. So, here we use the relation V is equals to omega root of A square minus X square to calculate amplitude of SHMs. So, here we can see for pendulum A, we can use V1 is equals to its omega, we can write as root G by L. As for both of these pendulums, the angular frequency we can write as root of G by L. So, this root G by L multiplied by root of A1 square minus distance from mean position is L alpha. So, this L alpha whole square, which gives us the value of A1. And on simplifying, we are getting amplitude of first pendulum is given as L square alpha square plus V1 square L by G. Similarly, we can write for B as V2 is equals to root of G by L multiplied by under the root A2 square. A2, I am taking the amplitude of pendulum B minus L beta square, because initially it is at a distance L beta from the mean position. So, this gives us the value of amplitude of second particle, which is root of L square beta square plus V2 square L by G. And as we have calculated the amplitudes, we can map the two SHMs on circles. So, this is the circular representation of SHM of A, and this is the circular representation of circle of B. Now, in this situation, the first particle is moving toward mean position and located at a distance L alpha. As it is coming down, its reference particle can be taken on the left hand side going in this direction at angular speed omega. So, here we can say its initial phase angle is this, which is phi 1, and the value of phi 1 we can write as this value will be pi minus of sine inverse this angle, which is L alpha by A1. A1 we already calculated. And here the particle, or you can say the particle in SHM of pendulum B, is on the other side of mean position. So, it can be considered to be located here at a distance L beta from the mean position. And as it is going away from mean position, its reference particle can also be taken here, as we already discussed in concept videos, that always the reference angular speed of particle of which the projection is taken in SHM is taken in same direction as anticlockwise. So, at this position, its phase angle with respect to the same initial reference point is say phi 2, then the value of phi 2 we can see this pi plus sine inverse of L beta by A2. So, in this situation, we can find out the phase difference in SHMs of pendulums A and B is this delta phi can be given as this phi 2 minus phi 1. On substituting the values, this pi gets cancelled out, and the phase difference we are getting is sine inverse of L beta by A plus sine inverse of L alpha by A, where the value of these amplitudes which are A1 and A2 can be given by these two results. So that will be the final result of this problem.